Hey YouTubers, welcome to the Cyber Overwatch channel, I'm Pragmatic. This video is part 1 of 5 in my Nmap Scan All the Things series. I'll try to provide a comprehensive overview of Nmap and the potential this awesome network discovery tool has. In this particular video, I will cover what Nmap is and when it was developed. Additionally, I will go over Nmap scan phases. Finally, I will also discuss the installation prerequisites and the Nmap installation process. If you find this content informative and you are interested in cybersecurity, please like and subscribe to the Cyber Overwatch channel. Nmap, also known as Network Mapper, is a free and open source network exploration and security auditing tool. It is designed to help the network administrators and security professionals discover hosts and services on a computer network and create a map of the network. It uses various scanning techniques to gather information about the target network, such as identifying live hosts, open ports, operating systems, and applications running on the hosts. It also has the capability to perform vulnerability scans, identifying potential security weaknesses, and detect potential threats to the network. Nmap can be run on various operating systems, including Linux, Windows, and macOS. Its versatility and effectiveness has made it one of the most popular network mapping and security tools available today. The Nmap suite offers a range of tools that can be used in conjunction with the core Nmap scanning engine. The tools include Zenmap, an advanced graphic user interface and results viewer that makes it easy to navigate and interpret Nmap results. Nkat, a flexible tool for data transfer, redirection, and debugging that can be used to connect to network services or create custom connections. Ndiff, a utility for comparing Nmap scan results to detect changes in the network over time or compare scans from different sources. Nping, a packet generation and response analysis tool that allows for more advanced testing of network hosts and services. Together, these tools provide network administrators and security professionals with a comprehensive set of capabilities for network mapping, scanning, and analysis. Whether you are performing routine network audits or investigating potential security threats, the Nmap suite can help you identify vulnerabilities and keep your network secure. This video aims to provide a good understanding of Nmap, its capabilities, and how to effectively use its commonly used commands. By learning how to use Nmap effectively, administrators can better understand and secure their networks against potential threats. Nmap was first developed in 1997 by Gordon Leon, who goes by the pseudonym Fyodor. At the time, Fyodor was a student at Gordon College in Wenham, Massachusetts. He initially created Nmap as a basic port scanner to aid in his own security research and exploration. Over time, Nmap gained popularity among security professionals and researchers due to its powerful features and capabilities. As Nmap popularity grew, Fyodor continued to work on the project and release regular updates, adding new features and improving the tool's performance. Before using Nmap, there are some prerequisites that can help you better understand and effectively use the tool. Although it is not required, it will be extremely helpful if you had a foundational knowledge with these prerequisites. They include TCP/IP. While it is not mandatory to have an in-depth understanding of TCP/IP, it is highly recommended to have a basic understanding of the protocol. This will provide a solid foundation for interpreting the output generated by Nmap during a scan. The second one is command line interface proficiency. Nmap is primarily a command line tool, so having proficiency with command line interfaces can greatly enhance your ability to use Nmap effectively. Being able to navigate the command line, execute commands, and understand command syntax will be highly beneficial. Nmap is a powerful tool that is used for network exploration and security auditing. The tool follows a series of phases when it is executed. Let's look at the various phases of an Nmap scan and what happens in each phase. Phase 1 is script pre-scanning. First, Nmap performs a script pre-scanning during which the Nmap scripting engine uses a collection of scripts. The Nmap scripting engine, or NSE, is a powerful tool that enables users to gather more detailed information about remote systems. NSE achieves this by using a collection of specialized scripts. This phase is only executed if you request it without options like dash dash script or dash s capital C. However, during the pre-scan phase, Nmap runs only the scripts that require it, such as DHCP discover or broadcast DNS service discovery. These scripts are executed once per Nmap execution, rather than separately against individual targets. They use broadcast queries to gather information about common network services. Phase 2, target enumeration. Then Nmap performs target enumeration. During this phase, Nmap examines the host identifiers provided by the user, which may include a combination of IP, DNS names, CIDR, network notations, etc. You can even have Nmap randomly choose targets for you by using the -IR option. A scan list is a scan list of IP4 or IP6 addresses will be generated by Nmap based on the identifiers. This step is necessary in order for Nmap to perform further scanning. This process can be simplified if you provide a specific IP address, which then eliminates the need for a forward resolution. Phase 3, host discovery. Host discovery, also known as ping scanning, is the initial phase of network scanning. Its primary purpose is to identify targets on the network that are active and may require further investigation. Nmap offers various techniques for host discovery, ranging from quick ART requests to complex combinations of TCP, ICMP, and other probes. This phase is executed by default, and Nmap runs host discovery automatically at the beginning of each scan. However, you can skip this phase and assume that all target IPs are online by using using the -pn option, which disables ping scanning. If you want to quit after host discovery, you can use the -sn-n options. Phase 4, reverse DNS resolution. After determining which host to scan, NMAP performs reverse DNS resolution to look up the DNS names associated with the IP addresses discovered during the host discovery phase. This step is useful because host names can often provide insights into the function or purpose of a given host and can make reports more readable than simply displaying IP addresses. Phase 5, port scanning. During this phase, NMAP sends probes to remote systems and analyzes the responses, or lack thereof, to classify remote ports into states such as open, closed, or filtered. Port scanning is run by default, but if you prefer to not run a port scan, you can skip it by using the -sn flag. However, you will still be able to perform some of the later phases of NMAP, such as traceroute and partial NMAP scripting engine scans. Simply specify the command line options such as --traceroute or --script. Phase 6, version detection. If NMAP discovers open ports during the port scanning phase, it can often determine what type of server software is running on the remote system using version detection. To do this, NMAP sends a series of probes to open ports and analyzes the response it receives. By comparing these responses against the database of over 6,500 known service signatures, NMAP can often identify the specific software and version number running on the target system. This technique can be very useful for identifying potential vulnerabilities and determining the appropriate exploits or attack techniques to use. NMAP provides a wide range of configuration options and scan types to support version detection, including the ability to specify which ports to scan, which probes to use, and how aggressively to probe the target system. Phase 7, OS detection. OS detection is an important phase of network scanning as it allows for identifying the operating system running on the remote host. This can provide valuable information for further analysis and can aid in exploiting vulnerabilities that are specific to certain operating systems. When requested with the -o option, NMAP sends a series of probes to the target and compares the responses to the database of over 1,000 known operating system fingerprints. These fingerprints include network stack behavior, TCP/IP implementation, and responses to specific probes. By analyzing these characteristics, NMAP can make an educated guess about the operating system running on the target host. Phase 8, traceroute. Traceroute is a valuable feature of NMAP that allows you to determine the network routes to many hosts in parallel. By using the --traceroute option, you can enable NMAP's optimized traceroute implementation. This implementation employs the best available probe packets as determined by NMAP's previous discovery phases, which helps to ensure that traceroute results are as accurate as possible. The process often involves another round of reverse DNS resolution for the intermediate hosts, but this information can be incredibly helpful in troubleshooting network issues and understanding the topology of the network. Phase 9, script scanning. Script scanning is one of the most powerful features of NMAP. During this phase, most of the NMAP scripting engine, or NSC, scripts are executed, which is powered by the Lua programming language and a standard library designed for network information gathering. These scripts are executed for each target host and port number that they interact with and perform various tasks, such as detecting service vulnerabilities, malware discovery, collecting more information from databases and other network services, and advanced version detection. The script scanning phase is not executed by default, and you need to request it using the options such as --script or -sc. NSC scripts are highly configurable and can be customized to suit your specific scanning needs. Phase 10, output. After completing the various phases of scanning, NMAP compiles all the information gathered and presents it to the user in a readable format. The output options available in NMAP are versatile and offer several choices to the user, ranging from a default human-readable format to machine-readable output like XML, JSON, or even grepable format. By default, NMAP outputs the results to the command line interface or terminal. However, it can be redirected to a file using the greater than symbol followed by the file path. The NMAP install process will be different depending on the OS platform used, and in the case of Linux, dependent on the distribution as well. For Linux, the easiest option is to use a distribution that already has NMAP installed, such as Kali or Parrot OS. They are penetration testing distributions. In most cases, you would just need to perform an apt update from the command line and an apt upgrade from the command line, which I will cover in part 5 of the demo. If for some reason NMAP is not installed, you can run the apt-get install NMAP command. It may differ depending on distribution. It may be DNF, yum, zipper, etc. For distributions that don't have NMAP in its repository, you can download the binary directly from nmap.org. Whether you are downloading the already compiled nmap binary or would rather download the source file and compile nmap yourself, the download process is pretty simple. The first thing you want to do once you are on nmap.org is click the Downloads tab at the top right of the page. It brings you to Downloading nmap, where you can choose between Windows, macOS, Linux, or source files. For the purpose of this video, let's say we are downloading the Linux binary. I would click the Linux RPM link, which brings me to the Linux RPM source in binary section. Under the latest stable version, you would click the nmap RPM link to download. In the same section, the site tells you what the RPM command you would use to install the package. On my blog post on CyberSec, I document how to compile the binary and install nmap from source. I recommend going to cybersec.com and checking out the blog post if you'd like more information on how to install from source. For Windows, it's a lot easier. You just follow the first two steps similar to the Linux installation to download the binary. Once you execute the binary, you just follow the installation wizard. Now that we have covered the nmap installation process, let's go over the man page or manual page for nmap. I'll also look at the -h for help option and finally cover some flags available for scanning. The nmap man page is an invaluable resource for anyone using nmap. It contains comprehensive documentation on the command line switches, options, and arguments that can be used with nmap to scan and probe networks for security vulnerabilities and other information. The man page also provides information on nmap scanning and detection techniques, output formats, and usage examples. To access the nmap page, simply type man nmap into your operating system's command line or terminal window. It is an excellent starting point for troubleshooting issues with nmap commands and getting a better understanding of the tool's capabilities. Thank you for watching nmap Scan All the Things Part 1, What is nmap and How Do I Install It? On the Cyber Overwatch channel. This video is part 1 in a 5-part series covering the ins and outs of nmap. If you find this content informative and you are interested in IT, specifically cybersecurity, please like, subscribe, comment, and share. Nmap is a powerful and versatile tool, but I just touched the surface of what nmap can do. In this video, I provided insight on various aspects of nmap. In part 5, I will do a demo where I will cover topics that were discussed in the previous 4 parts. I recommend reading the documentation provided on nmap.org and practicing on a test network, as it can help you gain the knowledge and experience needed to use nmap effectively. The information discussed in this video is gathered from my experience and research. Use this information I provided in a way that can best assist you. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment, or you can send me a message from the www.cybersec.com website listed in the description. Until next time, keep learning, because the only way to keep improving is to keep learning. Pragmatic One, signing off.